We are lucky enough to be here with the man, the myth, the legend, Caleb Nelson. And Caleb, you are coming off a full week of entertaining, exciting, provocative, some may even say thought-provoking posts.
Definitely not thought-provoking. Who are we kidding?
I was trying to talk you up on...
That's hard to do, isn't it? if not impossible.
It's not usually hard to talk you up. But anyway...
What kind of up are we talking about?
You know, AlbanyCrossFit.com gets about 3,000 hits a day from all over the world.
Got to have Leb Week.
And it had Leb Week. So, after a week of posts... Well, actually, let's talk about this.
Week of posts?
Yes. What prompted you? Did you just decide... Did you come to me, Jason Ackerman, and say, you know what, Jay? I want to take the bull by the horns and do a week of posts, or did someone come to you?
We'll put it this way. I was punished. Not the way I usually like to be punished.
Dominated?
No, for...
I don't like to use the word punish.
No, yeah. I was enlightened. There was a need for me to be enlightened to reality. So, one day, you and Kev sat me down and said, Caleb, you gotta step your game up. So we're gonna make you have the opportunity to get better. That didn't sound like good English, but I'm gonna go with it.
But what you said, although it was very poor grammar, was...
No, thanks.
Was... We're giving you the opportunity.
Yeah.
So
more or less, you guys thought that I had more potential to tap into, and you're like, Caleb, time to step up. Let's do this. So I was like, Caleb, every night you have to write the post. You have to put videos up, which you still helped me with on a couple of
videos.
Well,
that wasn't that you can't do it. It's getting to learn the iMovie. I don't fault you for that.
More or less, especially with Clifton Park coming and me being a little more involved with that. You wanted me to have a greater appreciation for what was going on behind the scenes. Though I work here, I clearly spend 90% of my day here.
If not 100%.
If not 100%. I might as well set up a cot down upstairs or in the middle of one of the rooms.
In the men's locker room.
In the men's locker room next to all the...
Imagine waking up to that.
Oh, God. I feel like I'm getting teabagged as soon as I open my eyes.
Your alarm clock is a teabag.
Some wrinkly old shriveled stuff.
But now, in retrospect, it's been, we're almost at the end of the week. Do you look at it as, yes, that was actually an opportunity, or do you look at it as it was more punishment?
No, from the moment you guys called me out on perhaps my slacking, I was like, you know what? If they think this highly of me, I should definitely take this as a learning experience, and I want to be able to contribute as much as you guys do, at least in the tangible sense. You guys do the posts. The code, you program, you do all that stuff, all those little things that people don't necessarily see, but when you look at the website, you look at all the different programming, all the different newsletters, all that stuff, there's a lot of depth to that. And you look at the website, you can go, you described it this way once, is that you think of it like as a, how'd you say it? There's like multiple layers behind that. You look at that one screen and everything else opens up behind it. There's a lot of time and effort that's put into it, and I think people appreciate that, maybe not always to its fullest extent, but at least this was an eye-opening experience for me, to know that there is this much time. You definitely go home for hours, sit at your computer, write, and definitely edit video. That was the first one. That was time-consuming, a few hours on that. But
well, it sounds like what you're saying is certainly our members are appreciative, our athletes... do appreciate everything that goes into Albany CrossFit, but they may in fact not realize all the stuff that goes in. Speaking of, somebody's probably calling
popular.
Me.
But he's more popular than I don't get that many texts.
Yeah, it's not always cool. But well, some of them are. The sexts are cool, the texts not so much.
Yeah, feel free to send pictures and all that other stuff. We won't deny that.
But aside from the 10 wads a day, the specialty classes, people may see Jay, Caleb, Kevin, as well as the other coaches goofing off and having fun, but there is actually quite a bit of work that goes, so for example, you did the post every night. How long did it take you to come up with the context and the what was written?
Thankfully, last Friday when you guys approached me, I immediately thought, wow, I need a theme for this week, and I thought, what better than to describe kind of my journey and my process and kind of coming on, and then where we're going with CrossFit here at ACF, and then Clifton Park. And even though you hate when I say ACF, I don't care.
I don't hate when you say it. I hate when you abbreviate
it. I abbreviate it in the newsletter.
Yes.
It was more that I was like, wow, this I get an opportunity to speak from the heart and kind of show my appreciation for the things that have gone on here. You don't always get that opportunity with a lot of people, and I think people understand that. They see it in the way we coach, the way we verbalize everything we think about CrossFit. But I wanted to be able to just lay it all out there, open book, nothing, no filter. I didn't get too nasty in the
post.
I got a little edgy.
You could tell it was written by Caleb.
Well, aside from the fact that I said you get a full week of web at the start of the week.
Right, that was the first, indication that these were going to be written by you.
Yeah.
But what you and I actually just came from one of our favorite places, Starbucks.
Starbucks. That was my second cup of the day, by the way. So.
And that was a four shotter, so.
Too much caffeine.
That's why this camera's a little shaky right now.
Shaky the clown over there behind there.
But something you and I were discussing is, we like to, as much as we claim to be perfect, we're not always right. We don't make mistakes.
Definitely always right. Never wrong.
Never wrong.
We're not wrong. We're not always right, but we're never wrong.
Right.
That's what we said.
That's what we say. And, like you said, you kind of put these posts out there as a way of you saying, I wasn't perfect. I'm not perfect. And what we also like to do is include our athletes in a lot of the decision-making that goes on behind the doors, the closed doors of the gym and the business and Albany CrossFit. And
even this is the most recent one. I'd say the rest day we brought up. We pushed the limits a little bit. We kind of stirred the pot. But at the end of the day, if people don't want the rest day, we still understand that. We can jive with that. We want to be able to make mistakes with you guys. And I think you guys appreciate when we do try to push the envelope a little bit. We are progressive. We don't just sit still and wait for the world to come to us. We do go out there and we try to experiment with the best things out there, whether it's some aspect of fitness or just the programming or just acting a little bit ridiculous on a daily basis. Clearly, not many places will pump and gyrate and fondle.
Not many gyms, at least.
Not many. You have many people in general,
But like you said, we like to be on the cutting edge, and if we do make mistakes, it's not because we're sitting idly by letting the world and the fitness revolution come to us. We're taking, the reins, and we're doing our best to do what we think is going to make everyone here better people and better athletes.
Yeah, I think people appreciate that we're comfortable with our flaws. We know that we have them there. We're ready for people to call us out on them. And going forward, we want that to continue that type of relationship, because it's only going to breed success for us and then subsequently for you guys, because you're going to reap the benefits of all of that. When you fill out the posts or put comments to posts or fill out the polls and tell us what you think, even if it's nasty, I don't care. I don't care about getting criticism. I'd rather hear it than not. It's only going to make us think more about it. We talk far too much to each other. We spend too much time together. And that it's that kind of challenge that's pushed us to where we are right now. And if that stops, we're going to stop along with it. But going forward, we still want to maintain this relationship. We still want to get better. We're constantly going to try to improve. The day we think we're perfect is the day we fail. And I don't think we're ever going to be perfect anytime soon. So we've got you guys to thank for that.
Absolutely. Well, after this week, in retrospect, your punishment or your opportunity, coming down from your opportunity, coming down from me, handed down sternly.
Through the ages.
And so last question is, do you still love me?
I definitely love you.